हरिओम। इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑल दीज कॉन्सेप्ट्स, द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ सी शार्प प्रोग्रामिंग। वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाट आर लिटरल्स, वेरिएबल्स, डेटा टाइप्स, एक्सप्रेशंस। आई हैव गिवन यू एन असाइनमेंट ऑन ब्रांचिंग एंड लूपिंग। वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन व्हाट आर द बेस ऑफ राइटिंग ए मेथड इन योर क्लास। What are the different parameter types we have discussed? We have also seen what are arrays and array list. We have discussed the three types of strings: mutable strings, immutable strings, and regular expressions. We have also seen how structures are handled in C# programming. And we have seen a named integer constant which is called as enumerations. In this video, we are going to discuss what is an overview of a C# program. We have already written sample programs, but we are going to see the structure and the details of the program. We will also be discussing what are namespaces, how to create your own namespace. We will also be discussing what are command line arguments. If you take C# program, there are two different categories of C# programs. One, you can create executable programs, or you can create library programs. Your executable programs will have an extension .exe. Your library programs will have an extension .dll. When I say an executable program, you can have three different types of executable programs: console-based application programs, window-based application programs, or web-based application programs. All these executable programs will be given to a common language runtime, which is the runtime environment of C# program, which will produce the output of the program. Whereas if you have a library program with extension .dll, it can be added as a component to any of the executable programs. These are the three types of executable programs. To these programs, you can add this .dll as a library or as a component, and it can be given to the CLR again for your execution. Then it will be producing the output. This is how a C# program is designed for execution. I repeat, C# programs are of two types: executable programs, library programs. Executable programs can be of console-based, window-based, web-based, and the library programs will have extension .dll, which can be added as a component to your executable program. The executable programs will be given to a common language runtime, CLR, which is the runtime environment of C# program, which will be producing the output. This is a sample C# program. As usual, you will have the using directive, add the namespace. If you want to have the basic system input output methods and classes, you must use this namespace. Define a class name. You must have a main method to initialize the execution. Then you can have set of statements. So in your C# program, since it is a purely object-oriented program, class declaration is very, very important. Anything inside a C# program must be defined inside a class. That is why we say it is a pure object-oriented program or fully object-oriented program. And we are all already familiar with these curly braces. The curly braces are used to define a block in your C# program. and the console dot write line here is the output line which is used for producing the output. And you will have a main method in C# program. You can observe here the main method is defined with capital M. So far in your C++ and Java we use only small m, but here we use it as a capital M because C# program follows a convention that all the class names and the method names begin with capital letter. If they have more than one term, something like this, demo, program, two terms are there, D is a capital and P is also capital. Now, if you want to execute this program, you can use a MCS compiler. Give your file name. The file name will be having a .cs extension. And if you want to execute, you can use mono and give the exe. As I told you, this will be a console-based application or window-based application or a web-based application.